Taylor Gang, let's get it.
Young Money.
Yeah. There's some people coming with me, and I know who they are. And some that just ain't gonna make it, and I know who they are. And I know they ain't gonna like it, but it's quite alright. I ain't need no one my whole life, and I've done alright.
Alright, you guys, welcome back to the channel. Today, we are going to be reviewing season 4, episode 7 of Love is Blind. We left off on Kwame and Chelsea getting ready to meet Chelsea's dad for the very first time. So listen, if this is your first time coming, thanks y'all for joining. I hope that you like it. If you're a returning viewer, thank you for coming back. #JulietClan. Period. So make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe to be notified every time your girl posts a video on this channel. And yeah, y'all, let's get into it. So y'all, it's 19 days before the wedding. Kwame and Chelsea get a knock at the door. It's Chelsea daddy. Okay, so everybody was already a bundle and a ball of nerves when they met and everything like that. Like, it really went smoothly. Like, her dad, it looked like he had a little reservations, but the more and more they talked, it seemed like the more clarity he got. Chelsea explained to her dad about the experiment. Kwame asked Chelsea's dad, though, could he have his blessing. I thought that was pretty dope. And he said, yeah, so you have one down, four couples to go. Paul's mom come into town, right? They meet up at this restaurant, and he's so happy to see her. He asked her how her trip went and everything like that, getting there. And she say everything went great, and she's so excited to meet Micah. And then she started asking Paul, like, what made you know that Micah was the one? And so he goes down his whole list of things and how they met and they upbringing. And Paul's mom just continued to kind of like be excited about them, you know what I'm saying, being married and taking things to the next level. I think she ready for grandkids, I'm just gonna be real. But I thought it was super dope. They also kind of act alike, and that's what Micah was kind of picking up on, is that they had like similar interests, Paul's mom and Micah. And so I think they're gonna have a really, really good mother-in-law, daughter-in-law type of relationship. Now, y'all, Brett decides, you know, hey, I'm gonna take Tiffany to see my apartment. Child, they done got over there to this apartment, and of course, it's Brett. So it's nice. It's a nice, really nice looking apartment. But when she goes into his room, she see all of these shoes, child. She see all of these clothes, luxurious shoes, and everything is just so nicely put. I think in a way she got jealous, because she's like, where are my clothes gonna go? I think that they came to a decision that if she does move in, like, they would have to get a bigger place, because he got a lot of shit. And I don't think she was expecting that. But I'm just like, he's good looking, okay? Why wouldn't you think that he had that many shoes? But anyways, so that went pretty well. She said she will, you know, be happy to move in with him. I'm like, yeah, bro, go on and move in, because it ain't nothing like a man having his own place and you coming to his place versus him coming to yours. It's a whole different vibe. Trust me, I know. Zach invites Bliss over to his place for a dinner date. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I'm just loving him. Like, I don't even know. Like, when we first did the first episode, I don't think nobody will remember who I chose. I'm sure I didn't choose Bliss. But if I could go back and choose, I think Bliss and Zach would be my favorite couple outside of, you know, Tiffany and Brett. They would be my favorite couple. I absolutely love them together. They mesh like this. Oh my God, it's just everything give me, like, period. It was just really a vibe, period. Period, it's just really a vibe. Chelsea and Kwame go to Kwame's place. Chelsea get over there, she like, I really like your place, but what the fuck? Like, he have shit everywhere. He wasn't nasty. It's just like, his stuff was disheveled. I think their conversation just wind up like revolving around kind of like do we move to Portland, Oregon, where Kwame lives, or do we stay in Seattle, Washington, where Chelsea lives? And I think Chelsea really would like to kind of be like the family-oriented type. She wants to stay in Seattle, so she wants him to move with her. And I feel like it's just going to cause a lot of tension. I think Jackie and Marshall, they talking about meeting each other's family, and today is the day, honey. So listen, Jackie, for some odd reason, stays like very tense. Like, she's a very tense individual. Today, I guess this in particular episode 7, they're supposed to be meeting Marshall's sister and brother-in-law. Well, she doesn't know, at least I don't think that she knew that she was supposed to be meeting his sister and brother-in-law. I don't think Marshall expected his sister and brother-in-law to like Jacquelina for whatever reason. And that's probably why Jacquelina was like all in a frenzy like that. But who's the sacred? Because I don't know. They sit down and they have dinner and they talk over dinner about how they met and first impressions and how they fell in love and kind of like how Marshall kind of like was very dreamy and he swept her off her feet and all the things. I don't know. I think they really like love Jackie. I don't know. They loved her. And so that's that. Period. Paul took Micah to his place. You know, I feel like she liked his space, but I feel like she felt like, you know, it was too small for the both of them because both of them work from home. Sincerely, he felt comfortable about having to move. I don't think any of the guys felt comfortable about the move, but even the conversation of kind of like, well, you know, the women picking it. Like, it's like, no, come with me. I think the man was more on the notion of you come with me. I don't want to come with you because I already have, you know, at least compromise. You know what I mean? But yeah, I think Paul's kind of taking that hard because I don't feel like he necessarily wants to just pick up and go. Neither does Kwame want to pick up and go. Kwame calls his mom, smooth things over, make sure everything is everything. And basically, when he called her, supposedly she wasn't approving of Kwame and Chelsea's relationship. She kind of took it really hard, and they didn't get a chance to meet Kwame's parents or whatever. I think Chelsea, you know, felt bad, you know, because I think Kwame's African, and so they have very, very strong values and stuff like that. So I don't know. Hopefully it works out. Brett and Tiffany have a conversation. Brett and kind of like budgeting, because supposedly he overspends. He goes overboard, and you know, he's very much into materialistic things. And you know, she just wanted to kind of make sure that they kind of budgeted. They bills was getting paid, okay? Because don't nobody want to be sitting up here. You up here got knew all of this tech stuff, and you expect me to pick up your slack? Absolutely not. And so they agreed to disagree that he would cut back on some of his spending habits and stuff like that. But I feel like that's kind of understandable because he was a bachelor. So that kind of comes with the territory. Like, if he's a single bachelor and he's very successful in his career, then what the fuck would you expect if he's been single? Same way with you. You know what I mean? But, you know, it's all new. So we'll see. And last but not least, because I know y'all want to know what's going on with Bliss and Zach, child. So Bliss and Zach go on a date, a boat ride. They're talking, and it's so dreamy, y'all. I promise you, it's like the perfect dream, a perfect fantasy. They're riding on the river, and they're talking, and they're eating fruit, and they're laughing and stuff, and winds up popping the question, and he asks Bliss to marry him. You know, that's where the episode ended, so we don't know if she said yes or not. But I'm just gonna tell you, I was shocked. Because I'm just like, okay, maybe they're just going to date. They're going to take their time. Because she said, you know, I'm still kind of, you know, hurt. But that's where the episode ended, y'all. I hope y'all is watching this or contemplating and watching it or whatever. Because it's really worth the watch. I promise you. And I also thank you for joining this video. If you haven't seen the other episodes, I implore you to go into the playlist. click it and have a ball and just see my review. But thank y'all. I really love y'all. And make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe to be notified every time I post a video on this channel. And yeah, until next time, y'all. Peace.